Today we will discuss the numerical on simple pendulum. So first example, that is a simple pendulum complete 40 oscillation in 1 minute. So number of oscillation is 40, time is 1 minute or 60 second. You have to find out frequency and the time period. Let's see the solution. First we will discuss the frequency. Frequency, the number of oscillation taken in 1 second called frequency. So frequency is equal to oscillation per second. Number of oscillation is 40 divided by time 60 second, that is equal to 0.67 second inverse or hertz. Second part of this question, the time period. The time period having a relation with the frequency, that is equal to time period is equal to 1 upon frequency. So time period we have to find out, frequency 0.67 second inverse. So the time period will be 1 upon 0.67, that is equal to 1.5 second. Let's see the second question. In second question, it is given the time period of a simple pendulum is 2 seconds. This is time period capital T. What is its frequency? We know the relation between time period and frequency. What name is given to such a pendulum? We have to also tell the name of such pendulum whose time period is 2 seconds. See, the time period is equal to 2 seconds. So frequency is equal to 1 upon time period. So 1 upon 2, that is 0.5 hertz or second inverse. What is the name of such pendulum? Keep reminding, a pendulum having time period of 2 seconds known as second pendulum. So it is written such pendulum is called the second pendulum. Question. A second pendulum is taken to a place where acceleration due to gravity falls to 1/4. First thing, second pendulum, so time period is 2 seconds. It's taken to a place where gravity falls to 1/4. Initial gravity, let G. After some time, the gravity becomes 1/4 of initial, means G dash is equal to G by 4. How is the time period of the pendulum affected? Means we have to calculate the new time period. Give reason what will be its new time. Let's see the solution. Let the new time period be T dash, this is T dash, and let this is G dash be the acceleration due to gravity. We have a relation, learn this relation. For two different time period and for two different gravity x due to acceleration, there is a relation. T upon T dash is equal to under root G dash upon G. Learn this formula. So if we solve this problem, we will get T upon T dash is equal to under root G dash upon G, or T upon T dash is equal to under root G dash is 1/4 of initial gravity, so G upon 4 upon G. G and G cancel, it will be equal to under root 1 by 4, under root 1 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2, cross multiply 2 will come here, so new time period T dash will be twice the initial time period. So T dash actually it is not T, it is T dash, that is 2 into 2, that is 4 second. Fourth question. Find the length of the second pendulum. So second pendulum means the time period will be capital T is equal to 2 second. At a place where G is equal to 10 meter per second square. Meter per second square is the unit of acceleration due to gravity. Take pi. Pi is equal to 3.14. Let's see the solution. See, G is given 10 meter per second square and the time period of second pendulum, that is 2 seconds. Let L, small l, be the length of the second pendulum. Now, from the formula, this is the formula of time period. T is equal to 2 pi under root L by G. Learn this formula. T is equal to 2 pi under root L by G. L is the length and G is acceleration due to gravity. So whatever values are given, keep here. So T, that is 2 pi under root L upon G is 10. If we square to both sides, or you can say 2 and 2 cancel, 1 will left, and then you square it, then L by 10 is equal to 1 upon pi square. So L by 10 is equal to 1 upon pi square. See, L by 10 is equal to 1 upon pi square. So L is equal to cross multiplied 10 upon value of pi was given 3.14 whole square. On solving, we will get L is equal to 1.0142 second. So length of the second pendulum at any place where acceleration due to gravity is 10, that is equal to approximate 1 meter. Actually, it is meter. See the fifth question. Compare the time period of two pendulums of length 1 meter and 9 meter. Length of first pendulum, that is L is equal to 1 meter, and second pendulum L2 is equal to 9 meter respectively. Let's see the solution. Let T1 and T2 be the time period of the two pendulums of the length L1 meter and 9 meter. Means T1 having the length 1 meter, T2 having the length 9 meter respectively. Because we know the formula, T is equal to 2 pi under root L upon G. So L is 1. So T1 is equal to 2 pi under root 1 upon G and T2 is equal to 2 pi under root 9 by G. See, in the root, if you are taking the root in complete equation, so 2 pi and 2 pi will cancel. In complete under root, it will come 1 upon G whole upon 9 by G. G and G cancel, so it will come under root 1 by 9. So T1 upon T2, that is equal to 1 upon 9. If you are taking out the square root of this part, then it will become 1 by 3. So T1 upon T2 is equal to 1 by 3. This is the ratio of the two time periods.